Welcome to Fragrance Facts. My name is Marcus. I test and wear a whole bunch of different fragrances to tell you how they are. This review is on a release from Chopal and it's called Musk Malaki. It's a 2017 release classified as an Amber Woody. It's a Eau de Parfum concentration and it's composed by Nicolas Beaulieu. Now Chopal are not known for making fragrances. They're mostly known for making watches. This is why the bottle cap has a wristwatch kind of a style to it. It's actually gorgeous, guys. And it's not plastic, not super heavy, but there is some heft to it. And also, their fragrance line of the Malakis are actually pretty good. And even if they're not known for making fragrances, I think this fragrance line does deserve your attention because the ones that I've had my hands on are pretty good. And I hope that I can actually get the ones that I'm missing because these have impressed me so far. Now, what are the main fragrance notes in Musk Malaki? We're gonna start off with the main one, of course, being the musks. And it's gonna be a couple style of different musks, but the one that I get the most of is a ambery musk. So it's gonna be resinous, it's going to be clean, and it's going to be musky. The second main note in here you're gonna get is leather. And it's going to be this leather jacket rugged scent. The third main note here is going to be tonka bean, but it's not going to be a sweet tonka bean. It's going to be more of a creamy scent that also has some little bits and pieces of sweetness to it. And you're going to get some secondary notes. And one of the most obvious ones is going to be the white floral smell of jasmine. And in here, what it's going to do is it's going to add some muskiness and amplify the musks to the amber, but also it's going to give it a clean and soapy white floral scent. And you're also going to get a secondary note of woodiness and a bit of black pepper, but the black pepper is mostly in the top. I will now explain to you the three fragrance stages of Musk Malaki to give you a better understanding of the smelling experience. So in the top, off the initial spray on your skin, you're going to get this fresh, clean, light citrus, but mostly musky aldehydes. And it's also going to have this black peppery spiciness, but it's light, it's not overly peppery. And you're also going to get this woody leather, raspberry kind of a scent that reminded me a bit of Tuscan leather from Tom Ford, but it's not exactly like that. There's just some vibes and sensations that will remind you of it. Because here they do use a chemical synthetic aroma ingredient of raspberry ketone and it's going to give it a bit of a raspberry touch. And the reason they do that is that it's often used with jasmine florals. And here there's a bit of an enveloped around cocooning of a white floral jasmine note that amplifies some musky elements as well as some clean and soapy elements. Then when you hit the mid, you're going to get again that muskiness that's going to be clean from that resinous amber. You're also going to get that white jasmine floral that's a bit musky, a bit soapy, clean. And you're also going to get some tonka bean here. It's going to be creamy and it's going to be a slight sweet but more creamy. And of course you're going to get that leathery scent with some woodiness. And in the base you're going to get again that muskiness from that resinous amber. You're also going to get that floral jasmine, white muskiness, soapiness, cleanliness, as well as the tonka bean creamy again. It's a bit more creamier here in the scent and also a bit sweet, but again, not too sweet. It's not a sweet scent and you're going to get some of that rugged leather, but the leather here is going to transition into more of kind of like a skanky, musky, dirty leather. So all of these notes amplifying the muskiness to Musk Malaki. And the whole kind of a fragrance is not overly floral, but that white jasmine floral that's wrapped around it just helps amplify everything of the muskiness, of the cleanliness, of the soapiness. So it's just an interesting combination here, but it does work in Musk Malaki. Let's jump into the performance for Musk Malaki. So it's an arm's length projection at a moderate noticeable level for the first hour, and then it quickly gets closer to the skin. It was a skin scent at about 5 hours, and I was able to detect it off my skin up to 20 hours. So from 5 to 20 hours, guys, a skin scent type of a fragrance, and it's a deep skin scent pretty quick. However, the Sillage was a bit better, but not that much better. It was, I would say, a moderate cloud surrounding your bubble for the first hour, and then that went down pretty quick as well. I remember 5 hours in getting little whiffs here and there of my trail, and when I had met a friend in a car in an air-conditioned environment, I was 8 hours in and he was able to smell it, and he told me that it smelled really nice. So this one, guys, I would say is below average in the performance category. You might get average if you overspray or spray your clothes, but this one is lacking in that department, and it's sad because it's actually quite a nice, unique DNA scent. And this fragrance, guys, is very linear. What you get from the beginning is pretty much what you get all the way down into the base. There are some little transitions, but nothing to write home about. But in general, guys, this is going to be a fresh, clean, soapy, musky, intimate, and more closer to the skin experience. So for the compliment factor, beside my friend, I didn't get any because of the performance. But when I did present the scent to other people, nobody said it stunk, it was not repulsive, but at the same time, nobody said unbelievable compliments. It was just that neutral, about 7 out of 10 reaction, where people said it smelled nice, it's pleasant, casual smelling, they would enjoy to wear it casually themselves, but nothing mass appealing or outrageous. Maybe again, if it had more performance, it would have a better shot, but sadly that's not the case with Musk Malaki. Other fragrances on the market it resembles. So of course, there's no clones of it, but I found that there's a bit resemblances in Tom Ford's White Musk, as well as some resemblances in Montal's Musk to Musk. But the fragrance I own, I find, is the closest, but you're going to have to eliminate the white floral jasmine soapiness, muskiness, because there's none. It's going to be from Givenchy and L'Atelier Givenchy line, and it's called Cuir Blanc. So this fragrance, guys, is the pretty much similar fragrance notes. It's gonna be musky, it's gonna be leathery, it's gonna be clean, but peppery as well with some spices. But yeah, this is the closest that I found to Musk Malaki, and it's a pretty nice fragrance as well. Now hopefully this review gave you information to help you understand this scent better. See you in the next one. Peace and lights out.